Today we're going to do a little review and comparison of two really sweet Sig Sauer rifles, both chambered in 5.56 NATO. The one on the bottom is a Sig Sauer 5.56 SWAT. It's a Generation 1 model. And the one above it is a Sig 5.16 Patrol. Both really great weapons. So we'll do a quick field strip. While we're in the house on each weapon, I'll start out with the Sig 5.56 and then switch up and go to the Sig 5.16. We'll take those down, show you how they operate a little bit. And tomorrow is supposed to be really pretty, and we'll take them out to the range, put some rounds through them. Just kind of let you guys form your own opinion. All right, we'll go through a quick field strip of both of these weapons. Just break them down for you, kind of show you how they operate a little bit. I'll give you a brief overview of what I've done with this 5.56, starting from the back and going work my way up to the front. The first thing I did was added the double diamond swivel mount for basically so I can slap a buffer tube on this, and allows me to put whatever type of M4 style stock I want to on it. This particular stock is a Magpul. The UBR, I really like that stock. Put a Hogue pistol grip, like with the 522 review, I mentioned it in there. Hogue is only like one of two companies that are producing aftermarket grips for the 5.56. I've stuck Magpul M-Bus flip-up front and rear sights, and Trigicon ACOG on there, 4x32. Really nice scope, and a AFG, the Magpul AFG 2, the angle foregrip. And up the front, you'll notice there's a JP compensator on it. So let's go ahead and break this thing down real quick. I'm not gonna get too crazy with it. So you'll notice right here, there's a little spring lever. All that's doing is holding this charging handle in. So I'll depress that down, pull my charging handle out. The charging handle pretty much locks the piston system into the bolt carrier. So just slide this bad boy out. And for any of you AK lovers, you'll notice there's quite a similarity here to the carrier and bolt system. It looks very much like an AK. We'll walk around the front here. So for removing the piston system and the buffer, basically just rotate this out. The whole assembly will come out the front. And you'll notice there's our piston and the buffer spring. So I'll consolidate this nice little package here. Slide it all the way to the front. Just do the reverse. Press that little lever. Insert your charging handle. You'll see it's nice and locked in place. This gun is really tight. And you see we're back in operation. So we'll go ahead and switch these bad boys out. Get the 5.16 up here. And working our way from back to front, kind of tell you what I did with this gun. This is Tracy's gun. I haven't done a whole lot, to be honest with you. When I purchased this weapon, it came with the Magpul parts, the CTR stock, the MOE pistol grip. The only thing it didn't come with was the M-Bus flip-up sights and the AFG2 foregrip. And obviously it didn't come with that EOTech. That's a XPS 2.2. So we'll go into the field strip of this. Like other M4 systems, pretty simple. as you can see, the bolt carrier and the bolt, really no different than a standard M4, just like the gas systems. Unlike the gas system, this doesn't have the gas catchment tube above the bolt carrier. It's just kind of flat. It's got a divot in there, and that's where the piston strikes the bolt and sends it back. But really, it's not a lot different than a standard M4. Standard buffer tube and buffer spring. And that bad boy's ready to go. All right, so like I said, we'll take both of these out to the range tomorrow. Probably put a couple hundred rounds through each of them. And yeah, I'll let you guys form your own opinions on which one you like better. All right, so we're back with the Sig 556 versus Sig 516 comparison. Like I said, last night's video when I was going through the breakdown, as promised, we have a beautiful day out here. It's been about a week since we've seen any sunshine, so got a ton of ammo. We're getting ready to burn this up. I'm gonna dial in the EOTech on Tracy's 516. And then we'll set some targets up downrange and have a little fun. All right, so we've set up targets at 50 and 100. We're going to do a little accuracy check on both of these firearms. Got GoPros set up on both targets. They're basically just silhouettes, and then I've got two clays out to the left side of my targets. And yeah, see what we can do with them. I really like this gun a lot. The trigger squeeze on this and the reset is absolutely amazing. I like the 522. It's just very smooth. Obviously, for accuracy, I'm at a little disadvantage since I've got this sweet little ACOG on here. It's a pretty heavy weapon, so it doesn't hop around a lot in the first place, but when you got a compensator on the front of it, it doesn't hop around at all. You'll probably see a little bit more of that when we're doing some hip fire here in a little bit. All right, let's try Tracy's gun out. All right, so now we're shooting with the 516. This is Tracy's rifle. I say we're doing an accuracy test on it in comparison, but it's really not fair since that's got a Trigicon ACOG on it. It's only got EOTech, so what we'll do instead is we'll look at groups and holding tight groups on them. So again, 50 meters and 100 meters,
Got a little silhouette, GoPro on each, and two clay targets down there. And see what we can do. Unfortunately, we stuck the chair right in front of the second clay.
See if I can do a little trigger here. Put it through the chair and hit the clay.
You get it?
Yeah. So, okay, some little differences. Obviously, the optics are quite different. The trigger squeeze is much like that of a standard M4. Not real wild about the reset on it, but I mean, it's still good. There are some nifty little features I like about this gun. As you can see, it's got ambidextrous magazine release. The 5.56 doesn't have that. It does not have an ambidextrous safety. Not real crazy about that. The 5.56 does have that feature. Overall, it's a good gun. We'll go down and check the targets and see how tight our groups are, I guess. It was pretty cool that I shot through the chair and hit that other clay. I actually shot the chair and hit the clay. I don't know if you can zoom in on this. The chair was kind of in our way of that clay there on the left, so sometimes you got to shoot the hostage. So I put it through the chair and hit the clay. Alright, so we finished the little group challenge, whatever you want to call it, between the 5.56 and the 5.16. Now we're going to do some cycling. Some fast cycling, got some really fun targets, those sodas that we don't like really much. Got one set up at the 50 meter, another one set up at the 100 meter, got GoPro set up on both. GoPros are dangerous close, so hopefully I won't hit one of them. But let's see what we got. It's just so much fun. Like I said, this compensator, it's awesome for fast cycling. A lot of people run them on their race guns. Whenever I build me a legit 5.56 race gun, I'll be definitely sticking one of these on here. Makes it real manageable. But yeah, made some sodas explode. Made some clays explode. Good times. Since the Sig 5.16 is Tracy's, we figured we'd let her do the little cycle test and start pulling that trigger just as fast as she can. We've got two soda bottles set up for her and a couple clays. And we'll see how she does. You ready for this, honey?
I am. I'm really excited.
All right, well, tear it up. Like a boss.
Like a boss?
Tear it up.
Whole lot of fun.
I can't wait to see the GoPro.
Did you see those bottles?
Yeah, they definitely exploded.
Yes, that was fun.
All right, so got one more little shoot that I want to do. Got five rounds left. Got one more really nasty soda bottle set up down there with two GoPros on it this time. So let me see if I can put two rounds on that thing real quick and make for some really good slow-mo video. Try real hard not to hit that.
Huh?
Trying real hard not to hit that camera. I hit the camera or not, but the GoPro went flying.
Oh,
didn't explode. I think the soda bottle probably hit it. Alright, so we just got done putting probably 150 rounds, maybe a little bit more downrange. I had a really good time shooting these. I said I was going to do a review and comparison. I'll just go over some of the key features I like about both. I'm not going to say one's better than another. They're both SIG, so, you know, it's quality no matter what. One of the key things I like about the 5.16 is the ambidextrous mag release. I think that's pretty slick. Not wild that it doesn't have an ambidextrous safety. The gun shoots sweet. Held some pretty tight groups with just an EOTech on it, no magnification whatsoever. 5.56, what can I say? This gun is, it's amazing. If I ever had to have what I guess I have. Everybody calls a bug out gun, that would be it. I like how it operates clean, smooth. I like the ambidextrous safety on it. I don't like that it doesn't have a ambidextrous mag release. I think the newer models, the 556 XIs, do have that option. They also have the option of putting an ambidextrous charging handle. Yeah, overall, both these guns are sweet. Yeah, it was fun. Now we got to go home and clean these and clean all the soda pop off of the GoPros, and we'll finish this video up for you. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Feel free to subscribe to our channel. Share it. Add it to your favorites. Leave any comments or questions below, and we'll get back with you. Thanks for watching. Safe shooting.